In The Sacred Kind, the first installment of the series, we explored the phenomenon of redheads and the relationship to the cinematic sync web surrounding actor Andras Jones. This scarlet archetype can be found in the symbolism of the Beast of Revelations, and utilizing our creativity as viewers, we can see this mimicked in the innocent imagery of the Pixar movie Brave, where the combination of redhead and beast are seen together. And at the dawn of film history, in Fritz Lang's 1927 classic, Metropolis. We have already highlighted a rogues gallery of redheads surrounding Andras. Lisa Wilcox as his sister Alice in Nightmare on Elm Street 4, The Dream Master. Beth Bates as his wife Faith in The Attic Expeditions. In the TV show Alien Nation, where Andras is caught in a love triangle with his redheaded teacher and a teenaged alien. We can see this redhead figure appearing as Isabella Hoffman, his other mother in the movie Tripwire, as his friend slash nemesis, Anthony Rapp in Far From Home, and with Seth Green, who is inhabited by Faith in the Attic Expeditions. Now let's see how the redheads interact with another symbol.
Show me the beast!
That of the mirror. Observe the mirrors that gravitate to Andras on screen, such as in his death scene in Nightmare 4. Mirrors are a recurring theme in this installment of the Elm Street franchise. Like the scene in which Lisa Wilcox confronts Freddy Krueger through a mirror, covered with pictures of Andras. In Jones' appearance in Good Morning, Miss Bliss, later Saved by the Bell, he plays Deke Simmons, shown here bullying Screech in the bathroom mirror. The same camera effect is used not only in The Attic Expeditions, but also in Hurricane Festival, where we find Mr. Jones chatting through the mirror with Pet Boy, the character played by Derek Mears. Mears would go on to play Freddy's rival, Jason Voorhees, in the modern remake of Friday the 13th. Mears' name is spelled M-E-A-R-S, like Mears. And we find this rhyming pun repeated in the name of Far From Home's director, Myrt Avis. The mirror can also be represented as a secret window, ushering our hero into his accidental initiation. Here viewing a bastardization of a magical rite of passage in Sorority Babes in the Slimeball Bolarama and staring through another looking glass in the adult arcade known as the Dunes in the Prom. But not all of the mirrors in this Hall of Mirrors are mirrors. Some are TV screens, as highlighted in Joan's appearance in the Night Trap video game, which corresponds to the Attic Expeditions, as both films place Andras in a house full of cameras. It should be noted that in this case, the cameras are monitored by two red-headed twins. This reminds us of Mr. Jones's red-headed twin, Alice, watching him on TV in Nightmare 4, and the smashing of the TV sets treasured by Anthony Rapp's character, Pinky, in Far From Home, not to mention Tripwire, in which Jones pulls a Patty Hearst under the watchful eye of redheaded Isabella Hoffman through bank security cameras. Which brings us to Averill's Arrival, a film which is currently only available in German. The film is a modern retelling of the Oedipus tale. Here we find a new Babylon incarnate in Mr. Jones' mother lover, who sits astride a TV mirror and choreographs reality's dance with illusion. Note the intentional use of mirrors over and over, almost becoming part of the cast, appearing every 5 minutes or so, as if to make sure we're were paying attention. It's worth mentioning that Averill's arrival was filmed on location in Vienna, the birthplace of modern psychology. Having read Accidental Initiations, we can't help but recognize the sync this creates between Andras's film work and the work of his father, the noted dream psychologist Richard Jones, whose dream reflection seminars influenced Andras's own great work, Radio 8 Ball. Which we will explore in greater depth in the next installment of the series. For having established the symbol set of redheads and mirrors, there is just one more card to turn. The Magician.
Well, Robbie had a rough night the other night at the 8121. Out all night having fun, he rose from bed with the ringing in his head. The clock struck one, the room filled with sun, and he got up to wash his face, and he said, "What's wrong with the mirror? I'm not looking so great." He said, "What's wrong with the mirror? I gotta get it replaced." Yes, his stubble had grown across his cheek. Overnight, he could see it in the light, so he grabbed a blade, rolled down the shades, saying, "The light's too much for me." He couldn't see, he went and he cut his face. He said, "What's wrong with the mirror? I'm not looking so great." He said, "What's wrong?"
Sort of defeats the purpose, don't it?
What?
The mirror. You can't see yourself in it.
Laugh at this story, 'cause there's no way that it could be true. Poor old Robert's just absurd. But you know the facts and the names are changed, and it's all about me and you.